Sonic, the heart of your system.
Hi guys, welcome back to another GGF mod build video. Now today I'll be taking a look at the recent build I did in the Liquid Devil theme. So the guys at Power Color sent over their 6900 XT video card for me to do a showcase build, run some few benchmarks and go over the build which I'm doing here. Now just to clarify some things, this is the non-ultimate 6900 XT. I received this a little bit before those ones have come out. Those ones are very new, so I just want to make sure you guys are aware of that. Now, I was actually quite surprised that the guys at Power Color did send me this card. Now, this is quite expensive. Now, I was really expecting just the top reviewers to receive these, but I can kind of see where Power Color are coming from. They're not really expecting an in-depth review showing all stats against other cards. I guess they just wanted to see this card in a nice system and see how it looks, because a lot of reviewers are going to throw it in the test bench, get all their data, and that's really it. And that's really what they're meant to do, and that's what a lot of companies want. But I guess Power Color want to see their card, because I must admit it is a very, very good looking card. Probably one of the best blocked 6900 or 6800 XT video cards out on the market. And I guess I just want to see how it looks in a really nice system. And that's pretty much where I come into it. So this is the build here. If you haven't seen the time-lapse build, I'll throw it up here on a link so you can check it out. I really do like this overall blue, the black, sort of the blue coolant, and the rest of it being black and gray. So I want to go over some benchmarks first, and then I got some sort of answers for some of you guys. A lot of you asked about the pass-through panel on there. Does it come in the case? How do I do it? And so on. Things like the side skirt covers here. Now these come stock on the case, but they do come white. I did sort of modify them. I added the lines to match the GPU, and I do want to cover some other things. So for the benchmarks, the CPU is a 5800X. I did run this at stock and also PBO. PBO, I managed to get a single core of 5 GHz on each core. Of course, not all at once, but I managed to get each core running at 5 GHz at some stage. Now we do have 32 GB of Antec Katana memory. I really do like this memory. It just, when it's off, it looks nice. When it's on, it looks just as good. And the diffusion of it is very nice as well. Now that is 3600 MHz, which is what you want for a CPU like this. Now when it comes to the GPU, I ran this at stock as well. Well, when I mean stock, it was on the Unleashed BIOS, and then I did overclock it a little bit further. I ran it about 2600 minimum and then 2700 for its max. Now that ran everything fine except for TimeSpy. I'm not sure why. I've had this quite a bit. TimeSpy on a 6900 or a 6800, it seems to smash those high clock rates, and I had to run it all the way down at 2450/2550 just in TimeSpy. So let's jump in and check out the benchmarks. Now for temps, I was pretty happy with those temps overall. Now I must admit, the FPU test and the Cinebench, we were drawing nearly 160 watts. Now that's quite a lot for this little 8-core. I wouldn't say little, but it's not the highest end CPU. That's why I didn't go with something like a 5950X or a 5900, because this system is quite small and I was definitely limited on RAD space, considering I've got a PE240 I would class this as the back, and then a SE240 on the side. So I didn't want to throw in something really high end, and then that would affect the GPU. But in terms of the GPU temps, I was really happy, especially with the hotspot temp. You have to remember the hotspot temp is always going to be that 15 or so degrees hotter, and then you have the standard temp of the GPU, which is going to be a bit less. So yeah, overall, I was very, very happy with the temperatures. Now, moving on to some of the other things about this build, which is what you guys have all asked. First of all is the pass-through cover. That is the cover that is running over here. That's where all those tubes run into. Now, I do that on a lot of my builds. A lot of people think it's distro plates you can buy, but no, it's just a simple cover that just runs, has a lot of holes for the G1/4 pass-throughs, and they just go into the other side, whether it's into the back of the case or in this case, it goes into the middle compartment. So I normally just start off with some type of aluminum, whether it's normally 2mm, 3mm. I don't really go too high over 3mm. If it's a large area and it's supporting quite a lot of a large gap, I will go with 3mm. But this one was simply going over the case that was already there. So I went with quite thin. I'm pretty sure that was probably about 1.8, nearly 2mm. And then sometimes I decide whether I want to go all the way over or just a small cutout. This one, I went with a small cutout. I just made a bit of a design, and then I just, once I had the right size I wanted, I just secure it with some screws, one on the top, and then I think I went with one on each bottom corner, and then I just tap and thread those, and I can just screw that straight in, and then I just drill. I kind of drill them, I don't drill through the plate and then the case at the same time. I normally do all the plate first, and then I do the case afterwards. And then to get everything lining up, I get the pass-through cover mounted. It's just a fresh blank slate of material, and then I install the GPU, I install the motherboard, have to do all that, get all the right fittings you want, exactly how you want it, and then I just run some other pre-bent tubes I've got roughly to where it needs to go. Now the length, you're not really worried about. If it's a bit longer, that's fine. I normally just rule a straight line down. It's really getting the level right, and then you just need to check it, because once you do it, if one of these is off, they'll all be off and it just won't work. So that's basically how I do those pass-throughs, and then I either just vinyl wrap them or I paint that. Now when it comes to painting my cases and stuff, I use, so first of all, I always prime, I'll always sand, scuff the surface up. If I've been working on it, I'll sand it down, get it nice and not too smooth, but nice and clean, no marks. Then I use a really good primer, especially with aluminum. I use an SLS etch primer that works really nice. That gives you a real matte finish. It's a little bit rough and it's really good for a final top coat. And then I use this engine enamel. Now this is high temp. Nothing in here needs to be high temp. It is a computer. A lot of people think painting computer components, you need really high temp, but you don't. Nothing gets hot. Even sort of VRMs, like things I painted, that doesn't have to be high temp. It doesn't get that too hot. Most paints can handle pretty decent heats, but I use this high temp because it gives you a really good matte finish. A lot of blacks, a lot of even matte spray paints don't give you that nice matte look, but this one does, and I use this one. So that's what I painted that cover with, and I painted the motherboard with that and also some other things. And then you might have noticed on the chassis with the bars that hold it together, I did use the high temp again, but that is the metallic charcoal. So I wanted to go with something a little bit different because the bars do come black, and I just wanted to change the contrast between that and the overall case. But I didn't want to go too far down to a different color. I just wanted to keep it similar to what the case already was. But yeah, going back to the pass-through panel, just make sure you get everything straight, line it all up, and that is it. And then I added a power button up the top. Now you're probably wondering why I added a power button. For those of you who have worked on this Antec Striker chassis before, there is a bar that runs down here that I've completely removed. Now I do have another one of these chassis over here. If I just bring it up, this is from a previous build. It is a bit scuffed up. It has been sent around. This is the panel here, which is the, there's four of these, one on each side. Only this one has the IO, the power button and that. So in order to make this build work on how I wanted it to have the pass-through tubes all in this area, this bar was completely obstructing these tubes. So what I did is I basically cut it here. I had to leave it enough here just to sort of finish it off, and you could secure the support bar in. And then over here, this support bar screws into it. So I cut it off here, got rid of this. I don't really need all the USB and so on for a showcase build. And then I relocated, added a Vandal switch over on the sort of the top area there. I could have put it anywhere, but I just thought that area would have been nice. So yeah, cutting the frame wasn't too bad. I just had to repaint it once it was done, because once you cut something that's been painted, you will get a silver edge because the case is made out of aluminum. And now another area I want to cover is the FLTs. I'll throw some shots up. I don't want to spin this around. Now the 240 FLT, I've done this on other, not just FLTs, like distro plates and so on. I like to add my own backing to it. Now this is external. It's got nothing to do with opening it up and adding it on the inside. The one on this build, if you look at, I'll throw some shots up, it's got this really nice silver looking satin effect through the coolant. Now I simply grabbed some more aluminum and then I just cut out the, kind of like what the back of the FLT would be, just traced around it, cut a notch out for the pump, and then it just slides in. Now the material I use, and I've said this before, it is clear anodized aluminum. It gives you that really nice satin effect. And then I can add a logo on the top of that, and then when it goes on the FLT, you can see that logo coming through, and that's exactly how you can see it on the case itself. So yeah, that's pretty much simple job to do. Just trace around, cut it out, and then screw it to the back of the FLT. So I normally just mount it on, and then when the FLT goes on, it gets locked in that way. You could try and stick it on, but you may see that through the actual FLT. Now, another good idea to do that is you won't see any cables if you're using a clear coolant, a dyed coolant. You won't see any cables, any tubes, or anything looking through it. So I've also reached out to EK, maybe they could make some type of backing for FLTs, because a lot of cases, if you do put them on a side wall, you will see cables and stuff if you are using a light coolant. So that's something they can think about there. Now the side skirts on this chassis, they do come white. I do paint it. As I said, I use the same paint before. I prime it really well. Now when it comes to priming and times, letting it dry, time is in your favor. You never want to rush anything. I normally prime it and leave it for a few days. And then when it comes to the final coat, I can prefer to leave it for about a week to 2 weeks, because I find it really does take a while to cure. Depends what type of temperature you're working in, but if it's slightly warmer, it's not so bad. But I find that if I try and rush things and then I get my finger marks on them, it is really hard to fix them up. Now this design on here, I had some comments that some people liked it, some people didn't. This design, this curvy design, actually matches the new design on the Liquid Devil video card. That's how they've gone with the front. It has all those curves, and I simply just got the vector file from the guys at Power Color, and then I just printed it all out on my vinyl cutter. This is a, I'm not sure, some type of silver gray. I think it's anthracite gray. And then I just laid it over and just transferred them onto the transfer material. Then I stuck that on and just went all the way down. Now it is a bit messy on the backs because that's where it just overlaps. Like I could have cleaned that up, but when it goes on like this, you don't see it. And I didn't want to cut them too short, so then they might start peeling back. And then I just used a heat gun around the edges just to make sure they do bend and fold into place. So that's what I did on those on each side, just to kind of blend in the overall design. Because if I thought if I just left that black, it wouldn't really go as well. Another thing I did, I've done this on quite a few of these strikers, are adding clear side panels. You might have noticed in the time that's built, this one goes on like this, I believe, like that. And then also the front one, and then another one on the back. Now, if I was to put something like this on, I just don't think you get the same effect as a clear side panel. I do it on a lot of my other builds, not just this one. Then on the front, I actually modified this slightly. I extended it a little bit further. The stock chassis one only comes to about here, and it's a little bit short, and I just thought it looked a little bit odd if I recreated that one being so small. I'm pretty sure they do it so you have room to run tubes out. Well, this one I probably still could, but if you had a shorter video card, not as wide, your tubes would hit it. So because I was doing it just for this build, I made this panel a bit bigger just so it looked a bit more in proportion with the chassis. And this is simply, I think, 4mm acrylic. I just trace around it, and then I actually use a fine steel blade bit. I've tried using an acrylic blade on a jigsaw, but I found that actually chips it quite a bit, whereas I actually use like a bimetal really fine tooth blade, and that actually cuts it really nicely, doesn't leave any chips or anything. And then I just sand it around the edges. I start with a file, then I use something like 300 or 240 grit, then I move to something like 600, then I'll move to 1200, and I think this is finally done with 1500. So the higher the grit will go, the more clear the edges will go. Sometimes I like it real clear, sometimes I like it just slightly frosted. This one, I've gone with a slightly frosted look for it. But yeah, that's pretty much it on this build. Someone mentioned about coil wind, especially in a case like this. We all know that AMD cards aren't the best on coil wind. Yes, there was some on this card, especially once it was overclocked a little bit. And you are going to hear it more on a case like this because look, the video card is sitting right out in front there. Whereas normally in a traditional closed case, it is a little bit sort of recited back in there. Once you got the side panels on, it will dampen it. But being in a chassis like this, I could definitely hear the coil whine in most games. But yeah, that's pretty much it on this build. I hope you enjoyed this video. I wanna thank PowerColor for sending out this card. Thanks for them for thinking of me for doing this build and this video. And I'll probably start doing more of these mod build videos in the future because a lot of work goes into these builds and a lot of you guys probably don't see the little few little tricks I add. Things like, I'll see if I can take this off without hitting the tubes. Probably not. So this here is just a bent bit of, I think it's like 1.2 millimeter aluminum. It's just bent in a random angle where it goes out on an angle back in, and that just isn't secured in. It just slides over the PCI Express riser cable just to clean it up. You don't need to secure it down or anything because the riser cable is quite bulky. It just slides over it, kind of like a sock, and then it just keeps it nice and clean. And then you can really have any color riser cable you can because I do know they come in different colors. And also I want to give a shout out to EK for sponsoring this build. They've been sponsoring a lot lately, gone with the Magnitude block, the EK Torque fittings. Of course, the video card is collabed with EK with that block. So it was a no-brainer to go with EK all out on this build. But anyway, I want to thank PowerColor for sending me the card. I want to thank you guys for watching and see you in the next one.